my dear friends, now we are going to see about the twinkle twinkle animals in the sea, nothing but starfish. So do you all know the starfish or not the true fishes? Yes, the starfish or not true fishes. Let's see why the starfish are not the true fishes. Starfish, or we also call it as sea stars. Mostly nowadays the scientists are preferred to call them as sea stars than the starfish, because the sea stars are not original fishes. So because they don't have the fins, they don't have the scales. So these things, they don't have the gills also. So it will not come under the category of fish. So avoiding the name as starfish, they are calling it as sea stars commonly. Are these are very beautiful marine animals because they live in seawater, found in a variety of colors, shapes and sizes. All starfish resembles the stars, and though the most common have only the five arms, most commonly in this picture also you can able to see it has the five arms. Okay, so it can grow for more than 40 arms also. In certain creatures it can grow up to 40 arms, but very minimally it will have the five arms. The amazing sea creatures part of a group of animals which we call it as echinoderms. All the type of the sea stars will comes under a single category which we call it as echinoderms. Travel by using their tube feet. Tube feet is the characteristic feature of the starfishes. They can regenerate their lost limbs also. For example, in this five limbs, if any limb was being cut off due to accident or due to other predators, it can regenerate and grow into a new limb. And also it can swallow a large prey using their unusual stomach. So first thing we are going to see the fact is sea star are not fish. Although sea star live underwater and are commonly called starfish, they are not a true fish because they do not have gills, scales or fins like the fish do. Sea stars also move quite differently from fish. While fish propel themselves towards with their tail, but the sea stars will have the tiny tube feet and that will help to move along. So it is different from fish movement and starfish movement. Because they are not classified as fish, scientists prefer them to call starfish instead as sea stars. Okay, so they prefer to call it as sea stars. And next, sea stars are echinoderms. Sea stars belong to the phylum Echinodermata, that means related to sand dollars, sea urchins, sea cucumbers or sea lilies. Overall, this phylum alone will have 6,000 types of species. Yes, many echinoderms exhibit the radial symmetry. Radial symmetry means you can cut at any direction, you will get an equal piece. Meaning their body parts are arranged around a central axis. Many sea stars have 5-point radial symmetry because their body have 5 sections, means 5 arms. This means they do not have any obvious left and right half. So you cannot differentiate into left, this is the left and this is the right in the sea stars. Only a top side and bottom side view only will be there. So top and bottom only differentiation. There is no differentiation of left and right. Echinoderms also usually will have the spines, which are less pronounced in sea stars than they are in other organisms such as sea urchins. So the spikes will be less in the sea stars when compared to sea urchins, sea cucumbers. There are thousands of sea star species. Yes. So there are about 2000 species of sea stars. Some live in intertidal zone, while the other live in deep water of the ocean. While many species live in tropical areas, sea stars are also found in cold areas, even in the polar regions also. And not all sea stars will have the five arms. While many people are most familiar with the five-armed species of sea stars, but not all the sea stars have the five arms. Some species will have many more, such as sun star, which has up to 40 arms. Okay, which is very, in this picture you can able to see. This is the sun star, many, more than 5 arms, means 40 arms are there. And sea stars can regenerate their arms. Amazingly, sea stars can regenerate the lost arms, which is useful in the sea stars is injured by the predator. It can lose an arm, escape and grow a new arm later. Sea stars houses the most of the vital organs in their arms. This means that some species can even regenerate an entire new sea star from just one arm and a portion of sea star's central disc. If the portion of sea star's central disc alone is present, it can regenerate into a new starfish also. It won't happen too quickly, though it can be about the year of the arm to grow. So it takes around 1 year to grow into a new arm. So it takes a lot of period of time. It is not like a quick. And we have one more important character for the sea stars, that is, sea stars are protected by armor. Depending on the sea species, a sea star's skin may feel leathery or slight prickly. Sea stars have a tough covering on the upper side, which is made up of plates of calcium carbonate with tiny spines on their surface. A sea star's spine are used for protection from predators, which include birds, fishes and sea otters. One very spiny sea star is the aptly named it as Crown of Thorns sea star. So one more very interesting character of the sea stars are, sea stars do not have blood. Instead of blood, sea stars have a circulatory system made up of primarily of seawater. The seawater is pumped into the animal, the water vascular system, through its sieve plates. This is a sort of trapdoor called madreopterite, which is often visible as a light colored spot on the top of sea starfish. From the madreopterite, the seawater moves into the seawater tube feet, causing the arm to extend. Muscles within the feet are used to retract the limb. So, sea stars will not have the blood. The seawater itself will act as a circulatory system. Next, sea stars move using their tube feet. So, tube feet is an important character of sea stars. Sea stars move using their hundreds of tube feet, which are located in their underside. The tube feet are filled with seawater, nothing but circulatory, which the sea star brings in through a madreopterite on the top side. Sea stars can move quicker than those might expect. So if you get a chance, so visit a tide pool or an aquarium and take a moment to watch the sea star moving around, because it is one of the most amazing sights in the ocean. The tube feet can also help the sea stars to hold the prey, including the clams and mussels. Sea stars eat with their stomach inside out. Okay, so sea stars prey on bivalves like mussels, clams, as well as small fishes, snails and barnacles. If you are ever tried to pry the shell of clam or mussel open, you know how difficult it is? Yes. However, sea stars have a unique way of eating these creatures. A sea star's mouth on its underside, which catches the food. Now, the sea star will wrap its arm around the animal shell and pull it open just slightly. Then it does something amazing. The sea star pushes its stomach through its mouth into the bivalve shell and then digests the animal and slides its stomach back into the own body. This unique feeding mechanism allows the sea stars to eat a larger prey than it would otherwise be able to fit into a tiny mouth. And one more fascinating thing is the sea stars will have the eyes. Yes, many people are surprised to learn that sea stars have eyes. It's true. The sea stars are there, just not the place you would expect. Sea stars have an eye spot at the end of each arm. This means 5 armored sea stars will have 5 eyes, while the 40 armored sun star will have 40 eyes. Each sea star eye is very simple and looks like a red spot. It doesn't see much detail, but it can sense the light and dark, which is just enough for environments for the animals to live in. So that is enough for an animals. And all the true sea stars are in the class called Astrioidea. Astrio, Astro means star. So in the class Astrioidea, all the sea stars will come. Starfish belong to the family, so belong to the animal class Astrioidea. Those echinoderms have several arms arranged around the central disc. So Astrioidea is classified as true stars. These animals are in a separate class called brittle stars or basket stars, which have more defined separation between their arms and their central disc. The sea stars have two ways to reproduce. Male and female sea stars are hard to tell apart because they are looks identical. So which is male and which is female, it is very, very hard to tell. While many animal species reproduce using only by one method, sea stars are but little different. The sea stars are little different. Remaining animals all reproduce by the same method only. So sea stars can reproduce sexually. They do this by releasing the sperms and eggs, which we call it as gametes, into the water. The sperm fertilizes the gametes and produces the swimming larva. So the development is indirect development because it has the larval stage, which eventually settle on the ocean floor, growing into an adult sea stars. So sea stars can also reproduce asexually through regeneration, which is what happened when the animal loses its arm. That arm itself will develop into a separate new organism. Okay, so these are the unique characters of the sea stars. So when it comes to the sea stars, you always remind the certain points which are very, very important. Okay, so the sea stars, minimumly it will have the 5 arms, maximumly it will have the 40 arms. And the sea stars are not a true fishes. Sea stars will come under echinoderms. And one more thing, sea stars will have the thousands of species. And not all the sea stars will have the 5 arms. And they can regenerate and develop into a new organism. And they have the armor, they will come because they come under echinoderms. And sea stars do not have the blood. So the sea water itself will act as a blood. Sea stars moving with the using tube feet. Tube feet is the characteristic feature of the sea stars. And sea stars have the stomach also. And sea stars will have the eyes, which will detect the light and dark environments. It cannot see clearly, it can detect the light and dark environment like sensors. And all the true sea stars will come under the class called Astrioidea. And sea stars will reproduce in a way like it will release the sperms and ovum into the seawater, the fertilizer.